Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Hyman. I'm the head of strategy and innovation at the Cleveland Clinic Center for Functional Medicine. I'm the author also of The Pegan Diet, 21 Practical Principles for Reclaiming Your Health in a Nutritionally Confusing World. And we are confused, and there are so many diet wars out there, which is really why I wanted to create a science-based, coherent, inclusive approach to nutrition philosophy that everybody could use to upgrade their health and improve the overall state of our planet. We really are facing a global catastrophe of chronic disease, which is now a double pandemic of COVID upon chronic disease. And most of that chronic disease is caused by eating the wrong foods and not eating the right foods. And the premise of the Pegan Diet is that food is medicine. It's sort of a spoof on paleo and vegan, because nothing really on extremes makes that much sense for most people. We need to think about what is the principles that guide us in eating healthy and eating for preventing disease and treating disease. And it's essentially this: food is medicine and quality matters. For example, if you look at two foods, it may seem similar. Let's say white flour and buckwheat flour. They're both flour, they're both grains, they're both starches, but they can be profoundly different. For example, white flour is made from a dwarf wheat most of the time. It's super starchy, that raises your blood sugar more than table sugar. It's also has many more gliadin proteins, which are inflammatory, that have been there because of the breeding that leads to gluten sensitivity. It's sprayed often with glyphosate, which destroys our microbiome in the soils, which is a weed killer. And it's preserved with something called calcium propionate, which has been shown to create autistic behavior in animals and hyperactivity and behavioral issues in children. Do you eat that, which tends to drive all these problems? Or do you eat, for example, a heirloom grain like Himalayan tartary buckwheat, has 132 phytochemicals, higher protein, minerals, low glycemic load, and actually can help to boost your immune system and rejuvenate your immune system, where the white flour will suppress your immune system, the Himalayan tartary buckwheat flour will not. And for example, I have a recipe for chai buckwheat pancakes in my book, The Vegan Diet, and they're pancakes made from almond flour and this buckwheat flour. And you can soon be able to purchase the Himalayan buckwheat flour. And it's a profoundly different food than if you're eating a regular pancake. Meat is also a great example, where if you look at meat and all meat, it's not the same. For example, in the one large study, they looked at those who ate feedlot meat compared to kangaroo meat. And in the feedlot meat group, their inflammation markers went up. In the kangaroo meat, it went down. So quality matters, and the information in food matters. And we need to really understand that. We need to eat in a way that regenerates our health as well as planetary health. And I'll talk about it in a minute. The second principle of eating well is besides quality and food is medicine, and understanding the way every bite of food regulates every system in your body, is understanding the personalization of our diet, because everybody's different and needs different things. Different ages, you need different types of food, different sexes, different activity levels, different health conditions. So the personalization is really important. And part of the book is designed to create a personalized approach, leveraging personalized nutrition for optimal health. So it's really important to understand that both we need to not be dogmatic. And I always say, don't let your ideology trample over your biology and eat in a way that that works for your body. So I feel that when you look at food from the perspective of a functional medicine doctor, the key is to understand that the body is one ecosystem. Even though medicine divides the body into all these specialties, right? You've got gastroenterology, neurology, cardiology, and so forth. The body is not actually organized that way. It's one interconnected ecosystem, and it's sort of a network of networks. And these core systems are all influenced by food in the body: your immune system, your digestive system, your detox system, your hormones, your communication systems, your structural system, even how you make energy are all influenced by food. And you can upgrade or downgrade your biology with every bite. And so functional medicine helps us understand how to apply food as medicine in very specific ways. Now, lastly, I think we have to think about the bigger implications of food and food system, which is the fact that our modern food system is not only driving catastrophic destruction of our health, but also the destruction of our ecosystems and climate. And when we look at the impact of our way of growing food, it's one of the biggest drivers of climate change, that along with food waste and ecological collapse. And so how do you eat like a vegetarian? And it's one of the principles I talked about in the books. How do you eat like a vegetarian and push the marketplace and push your own health toward wellness and push the marketplace towards a regenerative system? And I'm very hopeful that we're beginning to understand that our food and ag systems from field to fork to the landfill is the most important reversible driver of both chronic disease and climate change and ecological destruction. So lastly, what are the principles of the vegan diet? Well, there's a couple of things that we already talked about. One, quality is king. Two, ask yourself this question when you're going to eat. Did God make this or did man make this? Did God make a Twinkie? No. Did God make an avocado? Yes. It's pretty easy. Also, going along with that is be careful of labels. If food has a label, make sure it has ingredients that you know what they are that you would have in your kitchen. If you don't have maltodextrin or butylated hydroxytoluene in your kitchen, then you shouldn't eat it in food that's processed. Also, you should focus on eating a plant-rich diet, not necessarily plant-based, but 75% of your plate should be colorful plant foods. Meat should be a side dish and ideally regeneratively raised meat. And that's a whole other topic I talk about in the book. Lots of good fats, olive oil, avocado, nuts and seeds. Eat superfoods, eat weird food that is nutrient dense. We talked about flavor profiles and so forth. Eat real food and try to eat like a vegetarian, which is really seeking foods from places that grow food, that support the environment, that animals are grown humanely, and that actually restores human health. And lastly, when you're enjoying treats, enjoy them, but think about sugar as a recreational drug. So when you follow these principles and more that are in the vegan diet, I think you'll find that they're a good set of guideposts on how to choose the best quality food from all the types of things we can be eating, how to eat that's good for you and the planet and our society. And I believe by doing that, we can all solve these global problems together that we're facing of chronic disease, the economic impact of it, the social disturbance of those foods that have caused health disparities, and of course, the ecological environmental collapse that we're facing. So the possibility for redemption and renewal and regeneration is there. And I hope we all can be inspired to take a little step towards that journey together.